The purpose of this Application Excellence video is to give you a brief overview of how ArmorEdge Snap-on Coping Cap is installed. While the techniques shown here may be applied to most projects, this video is not comprehensive to cover all situations. We encourage you to contact Garland Engineering with any questions. This is a list of the standard tools needed for ArmorEdge coping installation. The primary components are the coping cap, splice plate, and anchor chairs. Coping components also include inside and outside corners and transition pieces. Accessories used with the coping include fasteners, caulking, and foam spacers. This installation video features products which require work along the roof perimeter. On most projects, fall protection equipment and observation is required. It is the installer's responsibility to ensure all federal, state, and local safety protocols are followed. Let's start with a brief review of how a coping is sized up. Measure wall width every 2 foot to 3 foot along entire wall length to establish minimum and maximum wall widths. When filling out an order form, right and left hand notations may need to be made. Left and right hand notations are taken from the roof area and not the ground. The reason is coping is installed from the roof edge, and the common left and right hand orientation would apply during the installation procedure. In combination with varying wall widths, these unique conditions can easily be addressed with welded transitional miters. The size, material, and attachment of the coping cap is ultimately determined by ANSI Spry ES1 approvals. Building code requires ANSI Spry ES1 testing for all metal edge systems. Note that a 6-inch face and 4-inch rear leg dimensions are the maximum lengths allowed by ES1 testing. Any dimensions less than these qualify. Large face dimensions need to be created with a face extender. Wall top surfaces must be inspected prior to the pre-bid meeting to establish a reliable scope of work and therefore reliable pricing. This will prevent the surprises of hidden conditions that will affect the project's budget. Although the parapet does not need to be perfectly level, it does need to be relatively level within reason and capable of providing adequate support for the coping chairs. For flat or level wall tops, this is a standard product application. In this case, we have uneven wall top surfaces which will require shimming to achieve a level mounting surface. Typically, 3/4-inch plywood or wood blocking is used to establish a level surface. In an effort to control cost, we are often asked, can we shim and level just at the anchor chairs? Initially, this seems like a good idea, but from a practical point of view, handling all the individual shims and leveling each condition can prove to be more time-consuming than shimming and leveling the complete wall with continuous sheets of plywood. It is easier to handle these large pieces than many individual pieces. Also, the continuous nailer offers the flexibility of positioning the anchor chairs at any location. As in all cases, be aware of the pre-punched holes in the anchor chairs. These holes provide guidance for the fastener locations and pilot holes for pre-drilling of masonry or concrete, either poured or precast. To be ANSI Spry ES1 compliant, anchor chairs must be fastened according to the coping test approval. The pre-punched holes in the anchor chairs are located according to that ES1 approval. Fasteners must be installed at these locations to be compliant. Check the crate for all components and for any damage before signing for the delivery. The following is the typical list of ordered materials. Apply a watertight underlayment to provide temporary water protection for sudden rainstorms. For most applications, a 40mm self-stick membrane is an adequate underlayment. Nail the membrane for additional securement. Read all installation instructions prior to installing the coping. Review the relationship between the anchor chair, splice plate, and coping stock length. Please note, the anchor chairs are 16 inches in length and the splice plates are 6 inches. These chairs provide support at both coping ends and at the coping's mid-stock length. Install the half anchor plate on one side of the parapet for increased support. Position the splice plate so it is centered on each end of the welded corner. Install the anchor chair into the splice plate and welded corner miter. This is the complete corner assembly. Place the corner assembly into position and secure at the exposed edges of the anchor plates using fasteners provided. Please note, large walls may require more than a half anchor plate or a custom anchor plate with modifications or custom springs. Pull a masonry layout string from the front of each of the corner miter anchor chairs to locate the front layout line for the remaining anchor chairs along the parapet. This wall has a slight bow inwards, and this layout line will allow us to position the anchor plates to a straight and true line. Typically, the anchor chairs are spaced at 60 inches on center. For higher uplift capacity, the anchor chairs can be spaced at 40 inches on center. For those shorter coverage areas, anchor chairs will be equidistant, but not further apart than spacing specified. Fasten anchor chairs with two screws into the top of the parapet towards the inside face and two screws to the outside face. Please note, all fastener holes have been pre-punched to properly locate the fasteners for compliance with ANSI Spry ES1 testing reports. Tapcon screws must also be used based upon this testing. The next step is preparation of the coping cap and splice plate for installation. Prior to installing the coping cap, remove the protective plastic film. Wipe splice plates clean for application of the butyl tape. Install one strip of butyl tape approximately 1 inch off the center line of the splice plate. This butyl tape will provide a guttering system to channel water away from the face into the rear of the coping. Then, center the splice plate at the end of the 10-foot coping section. Install foam blocking only on the intermediate anchor plates that do not require splice plate assembly. Engage or hook the coping's front drip under the coping chair's front kickout of the anchor chair. Position coping stock lengths to allow for 1/4 inch gap at the abutting coping joints. Rotate coping until the hook snaps over the inside leg of the anchor chair. Check to be certain the coping rear leg is fully engaged along the end and intermediate anchor chairs. Repeat steps for the remaining lengths of coping, allowing 1/4 inch joint between coping for expansion.